You don't always have to get married. You don't always have to have a relationship. You don't always have to drag yourself into things. I want to make this an important one because if you're overseas, you can meet people that you're friends. I know a lot of Filipino women that are just looking for a good friend. They're not really looking for a relationship. If it happens, it happens. But at the same time, they just want to connect with somebody. In the Philippines, you have this bubble. It's called the work bubble and the family bubble. Beyond that, there's normally very little time for anything. So in the work bubble, they'll often be chatting on the internet, etc. And when I first started talking to people about this, you start to see that people just like to have a friend. It's why in the Philippines there's this thing called chatmate. I don't know if it's the same in other places. These are people that actually get in touch with each other just so they've got somebody to talk to. I think it's great. I think it's important. I think it's important that people don't have that social aspect in their lives, have that connection. But also, I remember when I first met April, the it was a case of we were just going to be friends. I was quite happy. I had a good job, was buying a new car, I was buying a flat, and everything was on the up. So, with that in mind, and the fact that I'd finished on an 11-year relationship, another thing I was interested in was just taking my time. I had no interest in a relationship. I wanted a bit of time on my own. But what we found is when we started connecting, is the day we met, we started talking, and then we have talked every day ever since for over 7 years now. Yeah, without fail, we talk. We're not talking as much at the moment, although we still talk every day. The kids are keeping my wife busy. But at the same time, that connection was there. It was instant. Because we enjoyed everything. You know, it's like we take pictures of food, which people, well, why do people take pictures of food and they mark it on TV and comedies, etc.? Because we're interested in food. Only people that are interested in food will get it. It's one of those things. It's, you know, it's a bit like people take pictures of motorbikes or cars or whatever, and then you ask somebody what, you know, do you know what car there was, but it was a red one. You know, it's that if you don't get it, you don't get it. But the whole point is, we weren't interested in a relationship at the beginning, not for months. I'd say nearly a year. It was 9 months before we actually met, but the whole point is, there's a lot of people in the Philippines just want a friend. And realistically, if you're serious about meeting people in the Philippines, start off with being friends. Find people that just want to engage as a friend, you know. Be honest with them, you know, say, look, I've just come out of a relationship for 6 months or whatever. I'm not looking to settle down with somebody. I'm just looking for somebody I can chat to in the daytime or the evenings or whatever. Because for me, it was just so random with April. It wasn't something we'd actually planned to do. It was just that we just started talking and continued talking for, because it was. You know, I've talked about it, how I met April before, but there was that connection instantly. She's very attractive with her smile, etc. But at the same time, like I said, we become friends. It wasn't, you know when it feels like more, but at the same time, you haven't met in person yet. So we just chatted and stuff. And back then, we weren't really on webcam. Most of our stuff was text. Skype wasn't available on mobile phones. Most of the locations I was working, I couldn't get a phone signal either, so it's not as if I could Well, I didn't have a laptop then. The laptops, I think my laptop back then was £1,600, which I can't remember when I even got that. But the fact was, there was no modern technology like this. It's not like sitting here in front of the webcam. We didn't have that. We were texting. April would get into work at 8 a.m. That was it. Yeah, because I remember I used to. She would get into work at 8 a.m. And I'd be up like early in the morning so that we could talk on my laptop before I went to work. Now, bear in mind, that's a lot of commitment with somebody you haven't even met, but we just connected very well. And I would say doing that for months before you even headed to the Philippines is probably a good thing because you'll find out if you have that communication, if you have that connection, if you have somebody that shares some common hobbies, which is important if you're going to marry the person. But also, even if you're not going to get married, there is a great friend for connecting with, to talk to. And for them, it's the same because if you've got family problems or stuff, generally you struggle to have people you can really talk about those things with. Having somebody remote that you talk to on a regular basis that you really don't have a direct connection with can sometimes be good for a bit of breathing space. And for them, it's the same. You know, in the Philippines, it's the same because they have the bubble of the family, the bubble of work. Having you outside of that, they can talk to you about stuff they can't talk to anybody else about. And that's why you can be friends, but you don't even have to have a relationship. It can end up as a relationship. I'm not saying it wouldn't, or couldn't, but the fact is, I would build a friendship first. It's also much easier to build a friendship, especially if you're offshore. And that's why I say you don't always have to. Like, A, you don't always have to marry the first girl you meet, but B, you don't have to instantly go to there, bang, marry. Take your time. But also become friends before you run, walk. But also you can make some good friends. You know, you could have multiple real friends. That okay, you may not visit them all or see them all the time, but they exist, and they're people you can talk to on a daily basis. They're people that are interested in you as a person because Filipinos are like that. They're very interested in what you're doing. Even the most dullest thing can become quite interesting to some people that have no relationship with that. You having a new secondhand car. It's probably still 10 years younger than the car that even their mayor has in their town. So those sort of things are very interesting. You know, it's bizarre, but you get that connection going, but also you start to understand how each of you function, how your lives are so different, but understand how they're different. You know, what people do, how their culture works and everything else. It's opening the door into the Philippines. Well, thanks for watching.